people hustle pool. Some people hustle cars. But have you ever heard about the man who hustles stars? Jack Horkheimer, star hustler, director of the Miami Space Transit Planetarium.
Our episode for this week, Monday, September 23rd through Sunday, September 29th, is Brightest IFO of the Year and How to Find a Planet in the Daytime.
And now here to tell you all about tonight's sky and the biggest show of all, the universe, your star hustler, Jack Horkheimer.
Greetings, greetings, fellow stargazers, and yes, indeedy, this week one of the most often mistaken objects for a UFO is at its greatest brilliancy for the entire year of 1991. It is, of course, an IFO. I mean, if a UFO is an unidentified flying object, then an IFO is an identified flying object. And this incredibly bright object in pre-dawn skies has been identified for several thousand years by many, and misidentified by as many more. I'm talking, of course, about the brilliant planet Venus. And if you go outside any morning this week, about an hour or so before it starts to get light out, you will see dazzling, brilliant Venus high in the east, breathtakingly beautiful. And by the end of this week, Saturday morning, the 28th to be exact, Venus will be at its maximum bright for the year. And if you look at it through a pair of binoculars or a telescope, you will see that it is a huge, gigantic crescent. Also, if you watch it once a week or so throughout the rest of this year and the beginning of next, you will see that it will grow rounder and rounder, but smaller and smaller as it moves farther away from Earth and journeys back toward the sun. But what about that planet I said you could find in the daytime? Well, excluding the one we're standing on, which I dare say most anyone should be able to find, there is another planet that is relatively easy to spot in broad daylight, with the sun blazing away full blast. And that is Venus. And to find it in the daytime, simply do as the people at the Abrams Planetarium suggest and use binoculars. Simply locate Venus before sunrise and keep track of it as the sun rises. Make a mental note of just how far away it is from the sun, and then you should be able to find it with your binoculars all day long. But one word of extreme caution: whenever you use binoculars, be absolutely certain that you never look directly at the sun with them, because you could damage your eyes almost instantaneously without feeling any pain. So remember, if you want to see Venus in the daytime with your binoculars, mentally measure the distance of Venus away from the sun as the sun rises. Then look that same distance away and in the same direction from the sun, but not at the sun, during the daytime. And you should see it without any problem whatsoever. In fact, many people claim that when Venus is at crescent phase, the crescent is actually easier to see in daylight than in a dark sky. And by the way, make a mental note sometime this week of the distance between Venus and the second brightest planet in the sky just below it, Jupiter. Because although they are now about 22 full moon widths apart, by October 16th, they will be less than 5 full moon widths apart, which will make a pretty spectacular picture. So, out under the heavens with you to catch an IFO. And whatever you do in the meantime, keep looking up. Sky and Telescope, the leading monthly astronomy magazine that brings you Star Hustler, is pleased to offer free of charge a guide to binoculars and telescopes for skygazers. Send your name and address to Sky and Telescope, Post Office Box 9111H, Belmont, Massachusetts 01278. Enclosed $1 for postage and handling.